before going to do the shaping operation, we have to mark the workpiece, okay, by using a pencil or a marker, and we have to punch it wherever we have marked by using a punch, so that we can cut the material by using a shaper machine, so wherever we have marked. So this is what the material we have to remove from the workpiece by using shaping machine. So this is the aluminium workpiece we are using. So now we are going to do the shaping operation by using a shaper machine. So we can see how the shaper machine looks. We can see the different parts of the shaper machine also. Now I'll go one by one the different parts of the shaper machine. We can observe from the front how it looks. So now we'll go to one by one the parts of the shaper machine. So this is the base of the shaper machine, and we can observe the table. So this is the table of the shaper machine. This is called the machine vise used to hold the workpiece to do the shaping operation, and this is the tool holder, and this is the tool used to cut the material, and this is the shaper tool head, you can observe, and this is the ram used in the shaper. Here we can move the table of the shaper machine by using a handle. So now we are fixing the workpiece by using this machine vise. Keep the workpiece and tighten it properly so that we can hold the workpiece firmly. So now touch the workpiece or bring the workpiece near to the tool where we need to cut the rectangular slot, so that we can observe here. So for that we have to rotate this by using a handle and give the depth of cut by rotating this handle in the shaper head. Rotate this so that the tool will move down a little bit and it will move near to the workpiece and it will touch the workpiece. Start the shaping operation. Switch on the machine first so that we can observe how the tool is moving as the ram requires. Give the depth of cut by rotating this wheel handle in the shaper head so that the tool moves down and it will remove the material. So we can observe how the material is removed. Very small amount of the material is removed from the workpiece. So now continue this process until all the material is removed from the workpiece wherever we have marked, till the depth we have marked and till the width we have marked, so that we will get the rectangular slot after removing the material from the workpiece. So we can observe once again how it is moving. So like this, it will reciprocate and it will cut the material. Simultaneously, we have to give the depth of cut by rotating the wheel in the shaper head so that the tool will move and it will remove the material. So rotate this also handle so that we can move the workpiece. Slowly rotate it. So continue this process till you get the rectangular slot by removing
the material from the workpiece using shaping machine.
So now we can observe the workpiece where the rectangular slot is cut by using shaper machine. So this is the rectangular slot. So wherever we have marked, so there the material is removed so that we can get the rectangular slot by using a shaper machine. So this is the aluminium workpiece or aluminium material used for the workpiece, and the rectangular slot is produced.